Welcome. Today's guest is Dr. Lokesh Sharma. He is a trained microbiologist and biotechnologist. He got his PhD at the University of Amsterdam. Lokesh has worked at his institution for 25 years as a senior scientist, and he has an extensive experience as a project manager in European project and national project. Thank you for being here.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
So, Lorke, what is the added value from your institution to Model to Bio and vice versa, from Model to Bio to your institution?
Okay, Maria Teresa, as you already indicated, I work at Wageningen University and research. And in our group, it's a bioconversion group. We deal with a lot of, or we have experience with a lot of microorganisms. So microorganisms that can be used in food applications, but also for the bio industries. The institute is called Food and Bio-Based Research, and we try to use the side streams as well as possible. And partly it's by microbial conversion, but it can also be by chemical treatment. For instance, can we produce vitamins on the side streams? But also projects is, can we improve the storability of some foods? So without cooling, can you enhance the shelf life of certain products? And those are also type of products we work on.
So going specifically to the task you have in Model to Bio, which are the intermediate treatments and the bioprocesses models. Those two are elements of the simulation model Model to Bio is constructing right now. Can you describe what do they represent inside the final tool?
The Model to Bio, you have to see it as a chain. And a chain is as strong as it's weak as a link. So the models are as good as their input is. And that's from the calculation point of view, but it's also from the experimental point of view and what's already known in companies. So we need all the information together. And I think that, well, the two aspects dealing with the intermediates, so the storage and the processing and the transport, that's a part which is important. And then the next step is, well, currently, a lot of those byproducts are used for incineration, or for animal feed, but maybe there are better alternatives. I think those are two important elements for the complete chain.
You have to gather all the related information about mixing, separating, storage, transportation, in addition to stabilization, extraction, and purification and fermentation. What are the challenges that you, until now, have had to face to obtain that information necessary for this?
They identified a number of industries in Greece, in Belgium, in Spain, and in the Netherlands, which are relevant for the project. But as I indicated earlier, also due to the COVID-19, it's very difficult to obtain the detailed information from the companies about their processes and byproducts. So the physical contact was not possible. So we needed to develop questionnaires, try to contact people in interviews, but also search a lot for reports and that kind of things. And I would really invite a lot of agro-food companies to be involved in this project, to contribute to this project, but also at a later stage to see how you can benefit from this these results.
We thank you, Dr. Lokesh, for being here.
It was my pleasure, and thank you. But I also hope everybody who reads this, who looks at it, please go to the website and see what comes out of this very nice project. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.